Debt is exploding in this country. For the first time in American history, Americans as a whole own more than $1 trillion just to credit card companies. That's $8,600 for every household in this country, more than $3,000 for every single man, woman, and child in America, including babies. And that's just credit cards. Millions of Americans also have student loans, home loans, car loans, plenty of other debt. Are we reaching a tipping point for debt? This is a terrifying subject, particularly the credit card debt, because it's something that everyone can relate to. You sort of understand how it works if you're a consumer. These levels seem very high to me, are they?
Oh, they're very high. And what's even more concerning is the pace at which we're accumulating it. And in fact, the last 3 months of 2017, consumers racked up credit card debt at a faster pace than in the past 30 years. So faster than even in the Great Recession.
It seems like this is one of those stories that is never covered, but it ought to be. So here you have some of the biggest companies in the world getting kids on credit cards in college, charging rates that banks would never charge. I'm not sure it's legal for banks to charge. I mean, I had my staff pull this. So the BP Visa card, what's the interest rate? 28% interest. It's shocking, actually. It's usury. It's illegal in other countries. Why is that happening here and no one's saying anything?
Because people don't seem to have much of a choice these days. And if you look at what hourly earnings have been, decade after decade after decade, they've been growing at a slower and slower pace. People are barely making ends meet. And if you look at, like, the past 6 out of the past 7 months, hourly earnings have actually been either flat or they've fallen. So people aren't really making much money. But then you look at spending, spending's still growing pretty fast. Income isn't growing really fast. What are you going to do? Well, you're going to take these credit cards and you get desperate. Well, I think part of what we're seeing is that a lot of the financial services have really been struggling to make money anywhere because we've had these interest rates pushed down so low, and that doesn't give those banks much room to work to make money because you know, they take money from you into a checking account and then they go lend it out in like a mortgage or something.
Right.
Well, those rates have been so low that it's been tough for them to make money, so they've gotten desperate and they've gone out further and further into these you know, kind of edgy activities just to try and make money.
Preying on the weak,
exactly.
to bump their margins up.
Yeah.
Finally, what happens? You said interest rates, low interest rates. This is one of the many unintended consequences of Fed policy. What happens when they go up as they're going to?
Yeah, well, your credit card payments are going to go up a lot higher as well. They're going to be going faster and faster. And you look at what all this debt that's outstanding and your payments every month, even if you don't add anything more onto your credit card, your payments are going to get more and more expensive. And at the same time, it's not like that income's growing really fast. So people find themselves just further and further in the hole. And if we do get a recession, which is going to happen, right? I mean, we don't go endlessly. This is a normal cycle. You have booms and you have busts. That's a normal thing to happen. When it does happen, how are people going to get through?